Morning, it's Saturday morning, June 29th, 2013. It's about 5:15 in the morning. I am in Douglas, Wyoming, at a Sinclair truck stop. Broken wheel. 3.39 for gas, not bad. It's only 85 octane, but cars don't care. I'm going and get something to eat, something to drink, be on the road. Well, I came into the truck stop. Like I said, I try to exercise quid pro quo when I can. So I ordered the Mexican omelet, which is taco meat and hash browns. I don't get the toast. And it's huge. It's very good so far. And this is what you imagine a truck stop cafe to look like. What's Flo the waitress, or whatever her name is. A lot of trucks up here. She was telling me that this is a big oil and gas, coal town, and that they've actually been growing. Alright, signing off. Just get a look at the rest of the place here. This is Torrington, Wyoming. Population 5776. Elevation 4,106 feet, according to the sign I just passed. And this is over towards the Nebraska border. Northeast of Cheyenne, which is down in the southeast corner of the state. So I drove the Scenic Drive, and there was nothing that I would say extra special from the rest of the drive through Wyoming. Called the Scenic Drive on 26 and we're touring to the Scenic Drive. I would say skip it if you're anything special. And I'm at the Walmart parking lot in Denver, or actually in Aurora Centennial, somewhere there. And as you see, this storm came running in and it was on top of you before you didn't even know it. But I had just sat down to read a book. So, still have daylight, so it doesn't make a difference to me, although I had to close the windows. But the temperature is very nice now, thanks to the rain. I just passed Mile High Stadium, or whatever it's called now, where the Broncos play. And I just passed 6,000 miles. I'm in Denver. Just passed 6,000 miles on the trip. Today is July 2nd, Tuesday. I've been in Denver 3 days. Now, I thought the first leg was going to take 7,000 miles to get to Alaska. So I'm not going to Alaska now, but I'll probably hit 7,000 just to get to Banff. So underestimated the mileage. I didn't think I'd be doing so much driving in addition to the routes to get there. So I had tacked on 20 or 25% extra in addition to what MapQuest was saying. So maybe I should have tacked on 50% extra. Exploration. Welcome to Centennial, Wyoming. Population 270, elevation 8076 feet. I need to slow down to 30 so I don't get pulled over by the yokels. So I used to be trained here. Now, this is the start of the scenic route into what's called Medicine Bow Peak, Snowy Range Pass. Steakhouse. Barbecue. Now, Colorado is one of the small towns in Colorado like that. Do you see that old cop car? Okay. Land for sale. 130, Wyoming 130 West. Alright, so we're going to start the climb here, I believe. Unfortunately, the map doesn't say how long this pass is, but based on, I'm guessing it's about 30 miles, 25, 30 miles. Some animal just crossed in front of me. I had no idea what it was. Like Newton. Boy, I bet it gets cold up here at night, considering there's still freaking snow on the tops. Cold. It's got ice in it. If we're in Colorado, this would be Rocky Mountain High. Could still could be, but I typically think of Colorado when I think of that song. Well, that's the Flaming Gorge Dam. It's a bridge I'm gonna go over going back. I'm in Utah right now. South. Just gotta be careful how I walk here. Water is a good conductor of sound transfer, so I can hear the people down there in that parking lot. Hear them? Down on the dock, maybe? Can't even see them. See a boat out there. I guess they allow boats. What a beautiful evening. Wow. The sun is still quite strong. Put some money into the block here. Looks so nice, you want to dive in. Flaming Gorge Dam was located here at Red Canyon, partly to take advantage of the canyon's curve. The curve of the canyon also made an excellent site for the spillway and diversion tunnels. Extends upstream over 90 miles, provides a rest stop for migratory waterfowl such as geese and ducks. The canyons and cliffs around the lake provide favorable nesting sites for osprey, falcons, and golden eagles. Bald eagles winter here. Look out below. Wow. Tried walking across the dam, and they have like four police cars in the lot here, and they said that you can't walk over because it's a terrorist threat. They got cops all over here. See, there's two more of them in the parking lot over there. They said I can drive over and scare themselves to death. Alright, so this is the dam from where they told me I could go. I see where the flag is over there, right? I tried to walk across this way. Whatever. This terrorism thing, man, really generates a lot of jobs, doesn't it? How this economy would be if we weren't fighting all this terrorism. Oh, boy. Ah. Oh, this is one of the gorges, I guess. Very pretty. Probably a nice place to swim. Climb right down there and go swimming on that ledge. That'd be awesome. Doesn't say no swimming. They have this fenced off, though. But you can still climb down there. No problem. Let me just follow that path. It's probably chilly. If I got here earlier, I would have done it. That sky, beautiful. So, we stayed in one of these off-road parking lots, and I can hear some cows mooing. Someone up there. So I'm just gonna get on the road and get some views of the sun coming up on the water over there. Going fishing. Here it comes. Just about to come up. Payday loan places. Right across the street was Edwards or whoever investment company, so I thought that was very interesting. Payday loans and then an investment company on the other side. Well, coming down this hill, I've seen the most deer. They're starting to come out at night, and I pulled over to take some photos. Look at that. Isn't that lovely? Look at the colors on the side of the canyon. Smells like Superman up here. The sun's going down pretty quick. It's about another 80 miles back to the highway. So I'm probably, depending on this town up here called Manila, which is in Utah, right up near the Wyoming border, I may just, if there's a place to stay, I may just pull over and stay there, get up at dawn, and then drive the rest of the scenic road at dawn, and stop up in Rock Springs for breakfast, fuel up, and get to Salt Lake.
All right.
So we're on one.
Let's see Rock Springs, I think. Yeah, Rock Springs.
And it's a loop. It's called the Flaming Gorge National Recreational Area. There we go. I haven't seen anything on the roads, off the roads, as far as animals. I don't have to drive into the sun tonight. Not yet, anyways. I come back on the other side of the river.